Hey, good morning. Welcome to this morning's presentation on use of a multi-encoder to master the art of streaming and recording. My name is Leroy Chiao. I'm the Vice President for Aerospace and Medical Applications for Epiphan Systems. Before joining Epiphan, I spent 15 years as a NASA astronaut. During that time, I had the good fortune to fly four times into space, three times aboard space shuttles, and on my fourth mission aboard the International Space Station, I was able to do some work viewing video capture. I started life as a chemical engineer. I have 3 degrees in chemical engineering, but I got very interested in life sciences once I started flying into space and started experiencing firsthand some of the biomedical effects of human spaceflight. During my time on the International Space Station, I actually did do video capture using an ultrasound machine to do remote telemedicine, and it was that actually connected me to Epiphan, where I'm now vice president. A little history on the company. Epiphan was founded in 2003. Corporate headquarters are in Ottawa, Canada, but sales office is right here in Silicon Valley, down the street from Stanford University on University Avenue. We have over 20,000 customers. We're in over 100 countries. And in 2013, the company was honored as the third fastest growing computer peripheral company in the United States. So what I'd like to talk about today is multi-encoding for multiple destinations. More and more applications today is not just one video stream. You're going to be taking multiple streams of high definition video, and you're going to want to combine them in different layouts and different encoding schemes, and you're going to be viewing them on a lot of different things, from monitors, classic monitors, to tablets, to phones, and so your encoding needs are going to be different, and a multi-encoder will give you the flexibility to take care of all that. So multi-encoding basically will enable packaging content more specifically for your application. Okay, and so in each stream that you're recording, you have the capability to manipulate it and to do everything that you need to capture it in full definition, the source video content and the source audio in full resolution, full frame rate, things like that. You can put different layouts and backgrounds among your product, the final product that you want to stream. You can add branding, you can add your logo into a part of that stream or the recording so that you know, you can identify your company. Resolution scaling and frame rates, those can all be individually controlled on each channel of video that you bring in to record. You've got different encoding schemes, of course, so you can mix and match. You're going to be changing your bit rates, and also, of course, your streaming protocol will depend a lot on the device that you're eventually going to stream to. All of these can be controlled for each individual channel. So for event production, this is an example of capturing a lecture or a presentation. You're going to be recording both the presenter and the presentation. And the idea of a multi-encoder is that you can record each channel at full resolution. It's uncropped, full frame rate, and then you can create the product that you want to actually stream out. But you're going to have a recording of the original so that you can actually create multiple products later. So without a multi-encoder, this is the old-fashioned way. This is how you'd have to do it. You'd have to have two sources, of course, as you always would. You have a video camera recording the presenter on the top, and then on the bottom you have the presentation itself being captured from the laptop or from the screen. You would have to crop, you would have to scale, and then mix together. So you need a box at each one of these steps. And you have cabling connections, all these things that can fail, as we all know. And before you finally get to your final mixed product here, then you send it to an encoder, and you can record it into a separate encoder to stream it. So that's a lot of cabling and a lot of boxes to accomplish putting one product together that you can stream and record. Now with a multi-encoder, it's a lot simpler. With one box, you can do what all these other boxes do. You send your video camera to your multi-encoder, you send your presentation to your multi-encoder, you manipulate those images in the machine, in the box, and then you come out with your final product that you want to stream. Now the big difference, one big difference, is that you're recording both video inputs at full resolution and full frame rate. And so you have the flexibility to manipulate these later depending on what you want your product to be and what your output's going to be and what kind of device you expect people to be watching on. So this is a demonstration of how it works. You've got two video inputs. You've got the recording of a presenter, maybe another video stream, and then you put them together and you can mix and match. And right here, it shows you how simple it is to do with an Epiphan Pearl. You just drag and drop, where you want the images to go. You've got everything recorded in full resolution and frame rate, so you can change this and make a new product later. This can be streamed simultaneously while you're recording. This shows you the front of Epiphan Pearl. We've got a confidence monitor so you can see exactly what you're sending out or exactly what you're recording. You can see you can add your background and a logo, as I mentioned earlier, to make a custom product that identifies your company. And I want to emphasize again the importance of preserving your original input. So with a multi-encoder, you're capturing at full resolution, full frame rate, both the camera that's capturing your presenter as well as the presentation itself. And so the idea is that you can set it up on the fly what you want to stream out, and you can also record that product, but you still have the originals so that you can create another product or multiple products later using the recorded images. And this shows you how it's doing. Basically, what you're doing, if you do it the old-fashioned way, down on the lower right-hand corner, basically you end up with one product, one stream, one recording. It's already been cropped, it's already been scaled, it's already been reduced down in resolution, and you don't have the flexibility to back out of that to go back to your original resolutions to create a new product. You're pretty much stuck with whatever you created and set up in the beginning. So the multi-encoder gives you a lot of flexibility. Here's an example of a medical application using a multi-encoder, how the multi-encoder actually makes it possible. It enables you to be able to do this kind of work. Say you're doing an ultrasound examination on a patient. You're going to want to capture for medical files the full resolution of that scan. Okay, it's going to have patient information. It's going to have all the stuff that identifies the scan with the patient. But if you're going to be streaming it out for remote guidance, say you want a diagnostic opinion from somebody located somewhere else in the world, that person can watch in real time as you stream that video out, but you're going to need to do things to that video before you want to stream it out. You're going to probably want to get rid of the patient identifying information for HIPAA and other regulatory reasons. You're probably going to want to crop the picture of what you're seeing. You're going to want to do a custom layout, and you're going to probably lower the frame rate and maybe reduce the resolution in order to have an efficient stream that can be sent over the internet to maybe a low bandwidth place. So this is how you would do it. You would have, of course, the camera view recording the actual examination. You'd have the screen from the diagnostic machine, in this case an ultrasound machine, and you would have to crop and scale both and then mix it and send it out. Now, this is not possible to do with a classic solution without a multi-encoder because you can't record at the full resolution that you want for your medical records while you are mixing and streaming out at a lower frame rate or a lower resolution. So you really do need a multi-encoder and able to do this kind of work and preserve the original files for the medical records. So as I was just saying, the multi-encoder is going to enable you to do both simultaneously. That is, create that medical record at full resolution and then mix product that you can send out and stream for a remote diagnostics. This is me on the International Space Station while I was doing exactly that. This is what got me so interested in this technology. I'm not a medical doctor. I was barely trained to do basic sonography. But using this remote guidance technology, we were able to image each other's internal organs, bones, teeth, and even perform the first ocular exams in space. So we were able to do both the bird's eye view of the exam in progress, as well as capture the ultrasound screen. It was the Epiphan technology that made that possible, the multi-encoding, to send it down to the ground so that we could effectively do telemedicine, consulting with the doctors, in this case at Henry Ford Hospital in Detroit. So this is our Epiphan Pearl. We saw this need, and we could do the solution with different boxes originally, but we saw this need, and so we created the Epiphan Pearl. And this multi-encoder captures all the things I've been talking about. You can see on the back of the unit, we have six HD inputs. You have two SDIs, two VGAs, two HDMIs. We have two balanced stereo inputs, and all those can be mixed and matched, and the system has enough computing power to capture four simultaneous HD streams and manipulate them. So this kind of shows you a summary page of what I'm talking about. On the top here, if you're going to use traditional boxes and cabling, you've got an SDI and an HDMI input, for example, in the examples that I've been discussing. You see you're going to have to go through splitters, you have to scaling, layouts. These are all boxes. All these are going to be boxes, encoders, splitting again, encoding again before you finally get to your final product and you want to record something and stream it. It's going to take all these different boxes and all the cabling in between. And again, we all know how cabling goes and how frustrating it can be to try to troubleshoot something when it's not quite working right and finding that bad cable. In the case of a Perl, a multi-encoder like Perl, it's one unit. You input your high-definition inputs. It records both streams at original frame rates, at both original resolutions, and then you have the flexibility, you have those recorded, you have the flexibility to create whatever product you need, whatever combination of picture in picture or side by side, whatever scaling has to be done, or frame rate reduction, resolution reductions, so that you can stream it out to the appropriate unit and you can view it, you can tailor it for whatever you're trying to view your video source on, whether it's a mobile phone or whether it's a tablet or a full resolution video monitor. So again, it's increased reliability. You don't have all those cables and all those boxes. It's easy to use. It's one unit to that front screen that you saw, the confidence monitor. You can do limited configuration and commanding from that monitor. You can start and stop recording. It shows you exactly what's going on, and so that you have confidence that the product that you're sending out is exactly what you want. It's also lower price when you add up what it would cost to buy all those other units, the splitters, the encoders, and everything else, and the cabling. If you're taking it to a show, which we all do. You want to minimize the number of things that you have to bring, the number of cables you have to bring. It's real frustrating, again, if you get to a show and you realize you've forgotten a set of cables and you've got to go run out to the local store and try to find it before the show starts. So just to recap, why do we want to use a multi-encoder? It's just flexibility, okay? You can re-edit post-production what you've done. You're recording everything in full resolution and full frame rate. It enables new applications and markets like the one I just described, doing telemedicine using an ultrasound or other diagnostic machine. And so with that, I'd just like to thank you for your attention and be happy to answer any questions. Thank you. Okay, thanks.